Welcome once again, everyone, to this week's Race to IAS Current Affairs Guru. I hope everybody is doing great. Let's look at some of the important current events that has happened between 16th and the 23rd April. The first one is regarding the RU-Sync stethoscope. It is a device invented by a startup based at IIT Bombay, which converts a conventional stethoscope into a digital one. Using this device, the heart and lung sounds can be amplified, recorded, and shared. The advantage of this device is that it reduces the need of physical contact by the healthcare professionals with the patients, and thus it reduces the risk of contracting the COVID-19 virus. Next is regarding the South Asia Economic Focus Report released by World Bank. The report forecast a sharp economic fall in each of the region's 8 countries. Which all are the 8 countries of the South Asian region? They are Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and Maldives. The report states that the regional growth will get dropped to a range between 1.8% and 2.8% in 2020, down from 6.3% that was projected 6 months ago. And the cause of the sharp economic fall, as we all know, has been stated as the halting economic activity, collapsing trade, as well as greater stress on the financial and banking sectors, which is a result of COVID-19 outbreak. Next is regarding a similar report by IMF or International Monetary Fund. The World Economic Outlook by IMF expects that the world economy will shrink by 3% due to the impact of COVID-19. As per the report, India's growth is expected to dip to 1.9% in 2020 and rebound to 7.4% in 2021. And this slide provides some information regarding the International Monetary Fund. It is an organization of 189 countries established in 1945 after the Second World War to ensure the stability of the international monetary system. Some other facts regarding the organization is given in the slide. Those who want can pause the video and read. Next is regarding Global Journalism Emergency Relief Fund, which is launched by Google. It is launched through the Google News Initiative, and its purpose is to support small and medium-sized news organizations producing original news for local communities. The fund's aim is to support the production of original journalism for local communities in the face of the COVID-19 pandemic. Operating globally, it will provide an easily accessible route to financial assistance at this critical time. Next is regarding a webinar series called Dekho Apna Desh, launched by Tourism Ministry. This unique series has been launched by the Tourism Ministry to provide information on many destinations, culture, and heritage of India. The next news item speaks about World Art Day, which is celebrated on 15th April every year. This day is being celebrated all over the world to emphasize the importance of art that nurtures creativity, innovation, and cultural diversity of all peoples across the globe. Next, the United States has announced the sale of Harpoon air-launched anti-ship missiles and Mark 54 lightweight torpedoes to India to strengthen its defense arsenal. And this deal is estimated to cost around $155 million to India. Next is regarding the integrated geospatial platform called Sahyog, rolled out by the Department of Science and Technology to help in decision making during the present COVID-19 outbreak. What this platform essentially does is that it will integrate the information regarding the number of infected or the amount of death in each spot in the country to a map of India on a real-time basis. It will also complement the Arogya Setu mobile application for contact tracing, public awareness, and self-assessment objectives. Next is regarding World Hemophilia Day, which is observed globally on 17th April every year. The date was chosen in honor of the World Federation of Hemophilia founder Frank Schnabel's birthday. This day is observed to raise awareness for hemophilia and other bleeding disorders. The theme of World Hemophilia Day 2020 is that get involved. Next is regarding Feifei, the new mascot for Hangzhou 2020 Asian Para Games. The 4th Asian Para Games are going to be held from October 9 to 15. 2022, featuring 22 sports with a taekwondo and a para canoe to form their game debuts, which means these two games are going to be launched in Asian Para Games for the first time. The next news item says that WWF India, that is Worldwide Fund for Nature, has appointed World Chess Champion Vishwanathan Anand as its ambassador for the Environmental Education Program. As we all know, the Worldwide Fund for Nature is an international non-governmental organization working in the field of wilderness preservation and the reduction of human impact on the government. Next is regarding Kisan Rath mobile app launched by Agriculture Ministry to facilitate transportation of food grains and perishables during lockdown. The app will facilitate farmers and traders to identify suitable transport facilities for the movement of farm produce during coronavirus lockdown. The app will allow transportation of farm produce from farm grade to market and from one market to another. The mobile application Kisan Rath has been developed by the National Informatics Center or NIC. The next news item is regarding DRDO rolling out new products to enable COVID-19 disinfection process. The new products are automatic mist-based sanitizer dispensing unit and a UV sanitization box and handheld UV device to enable COVID-19 disinfection process. So what is automatic mist-based sanitizer dispensing unit? It is a contactless sanitizer dispenser which sprays alcohol-based hand rub sanitizer solution for sanitization of hands while entering the buildings or offices, complexes, etc. It is based on water mist aerator technology which was developed for water conservation. And what is UV sanitization box? It will be used for the purpose of disinfecting personal belongings such as mobile phones, tablets, purses, currency, cover of office files, etc. And the handheld device will be used for disinfecting office and household objects such as chairs, files, postal delivered items and food packets. The next news item says that Goa has become the first zero COVID-19 state in the country. This makes Goa the first green state in the country with no case of COVID-19 being reported from April 3. The next is regarding the new FDI policy formulated by India. So what is FDI or foreign direct investment? It is an investment from a party in one country into a business or corporation in another country. The Indian government classifies FDI into two: FDI under automatic route and FDI under government approval route. FDI under automatic route doesn't require the permission from central government, while FDI under government approval route requires government permission. Now, India on Saturday mandated that all the investments from neighboring countries, including China, would now require government approval. This effectively closes the automatic route for those nations through which an increasing number of foreign firms and individuals had begun to invest. And China says that India's new FDI policy is discriminatory and against free trade. Next slide provides us with the details of National Green Tribunal. We frequently see news regarding the National Green Tribunal in connection with environmental protection, right? So the body was established on 18th October 2010 under the National Green Tribunal Act of 2010 for effective and expeditious disposal of cases related to environmental protection and conservation of forest and other natural resources, including enforcement of any legal right relating to environment. It also awards relief and compensation for damages to persons and property in relation with the environmental cases. And the speciality of this tribunal is that, unlike the conventional tribunals, NGT shall not be bounded by the procedure laid down by the Code of Civil Procedure or Code of Civil Procedure of 1908, but shall be guided by principles of natural justice. There is some additional information regarding NGT in this slide. Those who want can pause the video and read. Next is regarding the National List of Intangible Cultural Heritage or ICH of India, which has been launched by the Union Minister of Culture, Prahlad Singh Patel. So what do you mean by intangible cultural heritage? Cultural heritage can be of two broad different types, which are tangible and intangible. Tangible means something which we can see and touch. This type of cultural heritage includes our famous temples like the Sun Temple of Konark, Ajanta and Ellora Caves, etc. Intangible cultural heritages are the ones which we cannot touch and feel. They include practices like a Kalamkari craft of Andhra Pradesh, Sowa Rigpa system of medicine and healing of Arunachal Pradesh, etc. So the government has now launched the National List of Intangible Cultural Heritage of India, which is a part of the Vision 2024 of the Ministry of Culture, and raises awareness about the various intangible cultural heritage elements from different parts of India at a national as well as international level. You can know more about intangible cultural heritages of India by simply doing a Google search on it. Next is regarding Wattbot robot, which is developed by students of IIT Ropar, which is in Punjab. It can be used to deliver medicines and food to COVID-19 patients in isolation wards without human intervention. Wattbot is also a feature of self-sanitizing on the return path and could be used for sanitizing walls of the hospitals. Next is about World Liver Day, which is observed on April 19 every year. The day is observed to spread awareness about the liver-related diseases. The liver is the second largest and the most complex organ in the body after brain. Next is about Civil Service Day. The Civil Service Day is celebrated by the Government of India on 21st April every year to commemorate the address of the first Home Minister of Independent India, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, to the probationers of Administrative Service Officers in 1947 at Metcalfe House, Delhi. The day was celebrated for the first time on 21st April 2006. The next news item says that Kapil Dev Tripathi has been appointed as new Secretary to President of India. He is a 1980 batch retired IAS officer at the Assam Meghalaya cadre. Next is regarding COVID India Seva Platform. Union Health Minister Harshvardhan on Tuesday launched this COVID India Seva on an interactive platform to establish a direct channel of communication during the pandemic. And how can we make use of this platform? People can post queries on this platform and get answers in almost real time. Next is regarding a prestigious appointment. Sudarshan Babu, a 1988 graduate of the Indian Institute of Technology, Madras, was appointed to the United States of America's National Science Board on Monday. He is the third alumnus from the institute in this institute from IIT Bombay to currently occupy the board. The other two alumni are Sivaraman Panchanathan and Suresh V. Garimella. The members are appointed for a period of 6 years. We are now presenting before you NewsUp, an exciting quiz competition based on daily news. The quiz presents before you an opportunity to win exciting prizes along with reading your daily newspaper. All you have to do is to go to Race to IAS website and register your name there. Any student studying in standard 6 to 12 can participate in the program. Duration of the quiz will be of 5 minutes between 8 to 9 p.m. from Monday to Friday. There will be no quiz on Saturday and Sunday. So all of you go to Race to IAS website now itself and register your names and participate in the quiz program. And in this way, you can make this lockdown periods much more fun and productive. So that's all for this week, guys. Don't forget to hit the like, share and subscribe buttons if you haven't already. And also follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok and Hello to get our regular updates. The links are provided in the description box below. Also, download our Junior IAS app from the Play Store for daily current affairs, mock tests and quizzes. We'll meet again next week. Until then, stay safe, guys. Goodbye.